Hello, hello, I'm Li Hao. Have you ever had this situation where you want to render different element based on different condition? So you have different conditions, but you want to render the same elements with the same behavior, passing the same attributes, have the same event listener, have the same text content, or have the same children elements within itself. Like based on condition A, you want to use a heading tag, heading 1, H1 tag. And based on condition B, you want to have a smaller text, so like a H3 tag. And maybe based on condition C, you want to change instead of using a paragraph node instead of heading elements. So this kind of situation maybe comes when you want to build like a certain component library. Sometimes you don't want to allow the user to specify whether you wrap the content with an element, but you can choose what kind of elements you want to wrap it around with. Say wrap it around with a div that folds with a full block formatting context, or a span, which is just like an inline formatting context, right? So how can you do that, right? Before we jump into that, let's take a look at one example. So example over here that I have, example one, the only examples that I've prepared, has an array called data. Let me zoom this up a bit for have a bigger screen. Okay, so we have data, which is an array, so which dictates how the document should look like. Right, so here I have a tag H1 with some content called title, div, and then content called hello world, content called lorem ipsum. Right, so all these tags, you have the same like tag name and content, right? So to dynamically render like elements, what you can do is to come over here for loop with an each loop, and you add if conditions, right? If it's the tag is H1, you use content. The tag is div, you add div. If the tag is italic, then you use the italic tag. Right, but this may end up a bit hairy if you start to want to pass in attributes as well, right? So say if I come over here and have attributes, let's see, maybe I just add some data attribute. So I just add ID equals to 2. Let me just quickly copy paste. I have ID 2, 3, 4. Okay, ID I should be a string, right? And here I will have to copy this logic and paste it in over every element that I have, right? So that each of them will have its own ID. If you inspect element and take a look, now ID 2, 3, 4 in each of the elements that we create. So every time when you have a new element, right, you will have to create another tag over here, like a span, right? And change it to span. So this, if this data is bounded, like we know all the elements ahead of time, then it's maybe okay to, you know, write through all of them. But this is really, really repeating ourselves a lot of times, right? So can we improve this to, you know, compress all this into one? Well, with 3.47 version 3.47, in Svelte, we released this new feature called Svelte Elements. It's something that a lot of people have been waiting for, especially people that have use cases that looks like this, like when they're trying to build a component library. You can have a special element called Svelte Elements that reduce all this duplicated code, compress them into one. Right? We've seen in a previous video about Svelte Components, where you can, based on different condition, render different components. And all of them, you can pass in the same props and have the same binding values and things like that. Right? This is the same thing. This is very similar to Svelte component. So instead of components, this is for elements. So it's called Svelte elements. So here, let me show you how you can use it. So in Svelte components, you create Svelte colon tag component, right? So now instead is Svelte elements. And in Svelte component, you have this attribute that says what kind of components you can pass in, right? Instead, we use this for the elements that we can pass in. So here, this, we're going to pass in tag, right? This tag. Of course, we need to make it an expression. And then inside it, you can have content, just like we had over here. And then you can have your attribute as well. So like this. And now we can throw all this away. And it still works. So this is Svelte Elements. Okay, so what you can do and what you can't do with this, right? Firstly, let's continue with like what the similarity with the Svelte components, right? So same with Svelte components, if you pass in null or undefined or any other falsy value over here, it will render nothing. So the whole thing will be disappear. So here, for example, I can say have a tag, content hello. Okay, so this tag I have, if I have a P, then you will see hello, right? A paragraph called hello. But if I pass in nothing, empty string, or some falsy value like false, undefined, see, nothing. Now, see, nothing, right? All these things will not show, will the whole thing will be disappeared, right? So this whole element will not be rendered if it's a falsy value and you pass a falsy value to this. So it's nice because you don't have to say unable to create an element called empty string or unable to create an element called undefined, right? So when you pass null, undefined, any falsy value, it will not show up anything at all. If you try to pass in, if you are naughty and you try to pass in like a function, of course, we'll throw an error because you can only pass in a string. Right? We can only document create element a string, right? We can only create a string element. Okay, so don't pass in anything like functions, array, objects, all these kind of things, right? It does not work. Okay, let me just remove this. So one thing to take note, of course, this works as like an element, right? So you can have, unlike Svelte components, it is a component. And what you pass in as a children for the component is the slot content. You can pass in default slots, name slots, and things like that. But this is an element. So anything inside is just the children of the element. Right? So you can, of course, have whatever you want inside here is just going to be the children of the element itself. Okay, so this is like one of the difference between Svelte element and Svelte component. And of course, like just like an element, you can add event listener. So on click, let me try maybe console.log content. So we try to click here, you'll see the contents being console logged out. All right, so this is just like an element. However, just like an element, I would say it's more like an element as well, is that you can't do binding with Svelte element. Okay, binding does not work at all. Why? We try to come over here, let's take a look at an example outside of Svelte element first. We try to come over here and create an input, and you bind value with a variable called value. Then of course, okay, let me take a look at this value. Now of course this will bind value of the input and it works, right? But if you try to come over here and change this to div, first thing you see is that value is not a value binding of div elements. Right? So before this, so you see this error on the left side rather than on the right side, which means that this error throws when you're trying to compile the code into JavaScript, not when you are running it on your like your browser and whatever, right? So on compile time, we already checked that where you're using the binding. If you're using it on a div, just throw an error out front to you telling you that, hey, bro, this is not gonna work. Bind value, it's not valid for div elements, right? You can only do it for input. So, over here, if you have a Svelte element, how are we going to know ahead of time what kind of elements you're going to pass in? right? Because this tag can be anything, right? Over here, you can see this is H1 div I. Well, you can know this is H1 div I by eyeballing, but Svelte compiler is not that smart. It has no idea what possible values you can pass in, right? So because of that, can't do binding at all. Because binding really depends on the element itself, and not just the element, and also other attributes. Say, for example, if you do bind value with inputs, you're getting like a text value out from here, right? But if you're adding a type equals number, then the value will turn into number during the binding, right? So there's a lot of magic that is being done during compilation time that needs to know statically, which means just looking at the code directly without no, like, does not depend on any dynamic value that you pass in the runtime. It knows this is an input element, this is a type number, so it can do create a special like dedicated number binding for your element. And this does not work when this element is dynamic. It can be anything, right? So this is like a shortfall for Svelte element, right? You gain something, you'll be very dynamic, you can be any element, but you lose something in the same time where you can't do binding, right? Because if you know how binding works, well, it's listening to the event, a change event or input event from the element, and then you pass, and then you get a value, and also you pass a value attribute in, right? So something like you pass a value attribute in for here, and you on input listen to changes and gets the event value equals to events.currentTarget.value, right? Let me try to have one input over here. If you're trying to change this, this feels like binding. Of course, you have to write your own attribute and event listener yourself rather than having like a nice way called a bind directive to do it for you automatically. Well, yeah, you have to do this with Svelte elements, right? So this is give and take. Okay, so what else can we talk about Svelte elements? I think this is almost all, everything, right? So you just treat it as an element. You can pass in any attribute, event listeners. You can also have transition, just like an element. Fade, let me add. Transition, let me see, how do I, okay. Should I like to have a checkbox? Check equals to value. And if transition still works. Okay, so don't have to worry about that. If you are doing a, let's see, if you are doing like a animate transitions, all these directives all works. Just bind does not work. Okay, if you want to use actions, it works as well. Okay, so don't worry about, just treat Svelte element just like any elements. Okay, and the this tag just like a Svelte component where you can pass in any string value about what text you want, and if you pass in null and undefined, it will be, the whole element will not show. So I think I can quickly show one more example now, talk about, since we have a transition, right? So if we change this, if we click this check, if we click a button, click me on click, and if we click a button and we change data, the maybe the first element dot tag equals to false, right? Once you click this, this will be undefined. So this, the second element will not show anything anymore. It should not show anymore. So it will play the transition. Just now, I hope you see this, right? Once we click this, this will be false. False means not rendering anything, and which means you're gonna remove it, And that means you have to play the transition because you have a transition fade to fade it out. Right? So you click, you'll see the hello world fade out and disappear. While I was editing this video, I noticed that I forgot something very important. In one of my previous video, I will attach a link to that video in the description. I mentioned that if we were to have a Svelte element, special element, I would hope to see that the special element itself would able to swap out the element itself, but keep the children nodes intact. Meaning, for example, if you have a Svelte element, and inside Svelte element, you have multiple elements, components, and things like that, I would hope that you would just swap out the Svelte elements and reuse the existing child components so you don't have to recreate all of them again. But while with discussion with the team members, we realized that I think in terms of API design, we would love to have Svelte element to be consistent with Svelte component. Meaning if you have a Svelte component, when it changes, the disk changes, basically the whole component recreates. Whatever slots that you pass into the Svelte component itself will recreate or will destroy it and recreate again. And same thing happens to Svelte element as well. So now when you use Svelte elements, be careful not to wrap a lot of things inside, because when the Svelte element, the disk changes, all the inner contents will be destroyed and recreate. I can show you a quick example of how that happened. So right now I have, let me create quick component over here, script. I think a best way to show this is to have a timer. So I'm gonna say timer equals zeros, on mount, set interval, and every 1 second, we're gonna increment timer. Right, so let me import on mount. So here, timer, I'm gonna show the timer. Okay, now let me import this component. And I'm gonna use this component within the Svelte element. Right, so now you see the timer is running. But as you change the type, I need a button to change the type. This will change to, span. Okay, now as I change the type, the timer restarts itself, right? Just now you were seeing that it was 0, 1, 2, and as soon as I change this Svelte element to a span, then the timer is recreated, which means this component is being destroyed and recreated. So if you have a lot of elements over here, right? If you have a lot of them, right? They will be destroyed and new ones will be created when Svelte, the disk value changes, right? So you will recreate all of them. So of course, so again, reminder, don't wrap it at like your root of your applications, you know, unless you don't mind recreating everything within itself, right? So that's about it, which is to elements will be recreated if you change the disk. And in that video, I mentioned about a workaround where we use a custom action to basically keep a temporary, store the children nodes temporarily, and then reattach it back to the parent after when we recreate a new parent. Of course, that also has its own constraint, but we'll leave the link of that video for you in the description and you can take a look at that one. Right, so that's it about Svelte elements. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you have any comments, feel free to drop them down in the comment section below. And that's all for this video. So see you. Bye bye.